Solve the next one determination, x minus 1, x, x minus 2, 0, x minus 2, x minus 3, 0, 0, and x minus 3. This is equal to 0 means, what is the value of x? Solve these determinants, they have to ask the question. So, first you have to think that, you cannot put plus and minus and all, and how to give it another one property. So, what is the property means? A determination should be like an upper triangular or lower triangular matrix means, the value of the determinants mean is the product of the leading diagonal. See that it is one of the determination. It is always one of the upper triangular matrix. The all the entries of this triangle shape, it is going to be zero. The value of the determinants is the product of the leading, that is main diagonal. It is called the value of determinants. So listen carefully. If you want to find out the answer of the determinants means, it is like one of the upper or lower triangular means, you can product all these three leading diagonal, it is a value of the determinants. It is one more question also. So directly how to write down that the determination value is x minus 1 and x minus 2 and x minus 3, this is equal to 0. So whatever maybe they have to given that any other matrix in case 1, 2, 4, 0, 7, 8, 0, 0, 9. So what is the value of the determinants they have to ask means you can product the main diagonal. 1 into 7 into 9. 9 sevens are 63. 1 into 7, 7 nines are 63. Therefore 63 is the answer of the determinant. Not only that upper triangular matrix and lower triangular matrix also 0, 0, 2, 4, 0 and 6, 7, 8 means, so it is always one of the upper triangular matrix. Therefore the value of determination is 1 into 4 into 8, 8 4s are 32, 1 into 32 is 32. So it is one of the properties of the determinant. So you can follow the properties, so you can product of the main diagonal is x minus 1 into x minus 2 into x minus 3. No need to product and all. You have to directly write out x minus 1 is always equal to 0. X minus 2 is always equal to 0. X minus 3 is always equal to 0. X equal to 1. X equal to 2. X equal to 3. This is the answer for this determination value. Solve means you can solve and find out the value of x. So x is equal to 1, 2, 3. This is the value of the determinant. And next one is 1, 2, 3, 1, 3, 4, 1, 0, 2, 18, 36, 17, 36. What is the value? So now I want to enter the solution. What they have to given? 1, 3, 4, 1, 0, 2, 18, 36, 17, 36. So see that I want to take out the 6 from here. How can it is possible, sir? 1, 3, 4, it is in 17 into 6, here 16 into 6 into 3, and 6 into 6, and 17, 3, 6. I should take out 6 from that second row, so therefore 6 into 1, 3, 4, and 17, 3, 6, and remaining is 17, 3, 6. See that two rows are identical, therefore the value of determination is 0, therefore it is always equal to 0, therefore the value of the determination, it is going to be 0. So this is a very important thing, you have to learn it. And next one, evaluate. So 1a, a squared, 1b, b squared, 1c, c squared equal to a minus b, b minus c, c minus a, you can prove it. So listen one thing, the another one properties of the determination. So if any two row, any two column, you have to add and subtract, you can write down that the related row or column. So I will give one example. 1, 2, 4, 7, 8, 6, 6, 3, 4. So this is one of the matrix determinants means. So the properties of the determinants, you can write down the row 1. So what is that? You can subtract from that any two row of the row 1. You can subtract R1 minus R2, you can write out the R1. And otherwise R2 minus R3 in the R2. So you have to subtract R2 minus R3 means you have to write down either R2 or R3. Either R1 or R2 or R3. This is a very important thing for the properties of determinants. Properties of the determinants. You have to add or subtract any two row, any two column that is possible for the determinant alone. So how I use the properties of the determinants for this one, 1 a squared, 1 b b squared, 1 c c squared. Here the book has given a, it is wrong. So therefore you have to write out that one only. So first one thing, I want to write out that R1. So where R1 minus R2. So what is that? R1 minus R2, I can write down in the R1. So what is R1? 1 minus 1, 0. B, minus, sorry, R1 minus R1, 1 minus 1, 0. A minus B. A minus B. And then another one is A squared minus B squared. And R2, what is it? R2 minus R3. You can write down in the R2. 1 minus 1, 0. B minus C. And next one is B squared minus C squared. And another one thing is 1C, C squared. 1C, C squared. So this is possible only for the determinant alone. So determinant, you have to interchange the row and column. That is not a problem for the row and column. You have to interchange all the three rows and three columns. The value cannot be changed. So therefore, I will change the row into the column. A minus B, B minus C and C. A squared minus B squared minus C squared and C squared. Now I want to find out the value. 0 and minus and plus. So 0 into anything is a 0. 0 into anything is, in case I want to find out the value of determination, 0 means this row and this column should be cancelled. I will product these two terms and multiply by the 0 means it is always 0. And minus 0 means it is always one of the 0 and plus 1. So this one only I will multiply. So what is that? A minus B. A minus B. B squared minus C squared. Here A squared minus of A squared minus B squared B minus C. So 1 into this term is a 1. Sorry, the same term. So therefore A minus B. Here I want to write down that B plus C and B minus C. Here A minus B and A plus B. Here B minus C. So I should see that I will take note A minus B, A minus B. And B minus C and B minus C. So I want to take note A minus B and B minus C. So what is the remaining? B plus C minus of A plus B. So A minus B and B minus C. So what is the remaining? B plus C minus A minus B. These two terms is cancelled. So therefore A minus B, B minus C and C minus A. This is a solution of the given determinants. Hence it is a proof. Thank you.